that we surrender to Jesus, that we must confess from our mouth and believe in our heart that Jesus is Lord. That's the humbleness that the Bible is talking about. It's directed to everyone, regardless you in the village or in town, that we must confess from our mouth and believe in our heart that Jesus is Lord. We must confess from our mouth and believe in our heart that we are sinners, that we fall short of the glory of God. Hallelujah. Because when we don't acknowledge, when we don't confess that we are sinners, that's pride. We don't want to acknowledge God. Our success, we don't want to acknowledge God. Fighting this pandemic, we don't want to acknowledge God. And God is trying to deal with that spirit, the spirit of pride and arrogance. Hallelujah. This morning I was at the Wailing Sea Wall. I was just crying to the Lord, help us, help me, help my family. So we can listen to your lesson. We can listen to your word that's speaking to us. Because we don't want to listen to what you say through the written word and through the rhema word. You are using nature. You are using things around us to speak to us. Hallelujah. And we already talked about that last week and the week before last week. The people who are called by my name, they must humble themselves. Hallelujah. God chooses the humble to lead, ready to listen, caring heart and ready to serve, accepting the hardship and barriers. God chooses the humble to liberate. They believe in their principle. They stand up for the truth and only the truth. The humbleness makes you a very strong person. I believe Moses was handpicked by God because of his humbleness. Hallelujah. God selected Moses because he was a very humble person. Hallelujah. And God can choose anybody this morning. If you are humble yourself and come before the Lord, surrender your life and confess your sin. Are you willing to repent? Are you willing to turn away from your sin? Are you willing to confess that you are a sinner and fall short of His glory? Hallelujah. Because we are saved through grace, not by ourselves or good deeds. We were saved through the grace of God. Hallelujah. So when we talk about the humbleness, we are talking about God chooses the humble to lead. God chooses the humble to liberate. Hallelujah. Not only to lead, but the other one, they'll come and liberate the humble, not the proud. People that they are proud of their achievement. No. The people that they are humble will lead us. And the people that they are humble, they will liberate us. And the people that they are humble, they'll start to perform miracles. Signs and wonders will follow them. Hallelujah. That is the most powerful thing when you are humble yourself before the Lord. Signs and wonders will follow you. You will be the person that God will use to liberate your children, liberate your family, liberate your company, liberate your village. Because the way that you live your life, the presence of God will be dwelling and manifest in your life. Hallelujah. As Isaiah 66, 1 to 2, it's on the screen. Thus says the Lord, heaven is my throne and the earth is my footstool. Where is the house that you built for me? And where is the place for my rest? For all those things my hand has made, and all those things exist, says the Lord. But this one will I look, on him who is poor and of a contrite spirit, and who trembles at my word. Hallelujah. When you talk about humbleness, that is humbleness. Hallelujah. God will select them because they are humble in their heart, contrite in their spirit, and they fear the word of the Lord. The world today, they don't fear the word of the Lord. That's why we face with pandemic. That's why we face with hurricanes.